The Nocilla Castaways know that I'm a big fan of Backblaze for my offsite backups. They were fantastic at helping me get started. This is video. I have a little B2 cloud storage piece of foam here so we can pretend this is a live demo of data. But anyway, I am here with Terry LoBianco to talk not just about that, but also about their B2 cloud storage. But start with explaining where Backblaze got started and what you've advanced it to.
Great. Now. Thank you, Allison. So the company started with personal backup about 11 years ago, and within about 4 years or so, we realized that we were managing so much data that we were a tenth the size of Facebook.
Holy cow.
And bigger than Box. So our business product developed more, and then we developed B2, which is strictly object cloud storage and very much focused in the media and entertainment space.
So what do you mean by object cloud storage?
It's a public cloud storage, so that gives you the ability to free up your on-premise storage, move your assets into the cloud to where you don't have to manage it, you don't have to worry about it deteriorating in any form. It's readily accessible. So with Backblaze, it's $5 a terabyte per month for storage.
Wow!
And a penny a gig for download. And that's it. So we don't put any requirements of how much data you should store, how long you should keep the data, what region you should keep the data in, if there's any reasonable limits about what you download. It's very simple and affordable pricing. That was the basis of the company in the first place, was to keep things affordable. And we can do that by designing our own hardware and software infrastructure. And we run the company lean and mean. And we just try to keep passing it on to the customer.
You don't seem to be that mean. I mean, there was another guy over there I didn't like.
I'm not that lean either, let me tell you.
A little both. So help me out here, though. So if I'm a video production studio and I keep my stuff in B2, are you saying we would do editing real time in data that's in the cloud?
Well, that's a great question. At first, we were just storage. But within the last 2 weeks, we have partnered with a couple of compute partners that gives you the ability to rent by the hour, either bare metal, which is a full CPU resource, or VMware, be able to do your transcoding editing project at an extremely affordable price through these partners, then move the project over into B2.
So it's sort of like standing up a server, reconfiguring it, putting all the data on it, doing your number crunching, and then shutting it down really quick.
Right, because you rent their product services by the hour.
Oh, that's a really interesting idea.
So then you can do transcoding and editing that way.
Wow, that's crazy. So can you talk at all about the price point on that?
I can't tell you the truth.
It just got
started,
right?
They're brand new partners. One is with Packet, and the other one is Server Central.
Okay.
Both extremely global companies, multiple locations. But with our partnership with them, we are using their facilities in San Jose, California area. So to do that type of scenario, there are no fees between the two companies.
Okay.
Yeah, passed on to the customer. So it's basically rent their servers, pay for our storage, and that's it.
And you're done.
It's a direct connect, and there's no fee attached to it.
This is kind of the dream that people have been promising for quite a long time. I remember companies talking about it 20 years ago.
Yeah,
and
we're very excited about it, and there was a lot of demand and asking for it.
Well, because people are working in different parts of the globe, and you can't expect all the data to be in one spot and somebody be able to get to it from someplace else. That's
correct.
The way to go.
Yeah.
Well, circle us back to, for the home consumer, talk about your Backblaze home backups. You're on the B2 side.
I'm on the B2
side. Okay, I'll tell you.
You know more than I do.
Yeah, ask me questions. So you download this. The big thing to me with Backblaze, well, the number one thing you want with an offsite backup is you want your data to be offsite. You want to be able to get to it in an emergency if you have a fire or a flood. Everybody's had a hard drive fail, but having your backup drive sitting next to your computer is a really dumb idea. Maybe you want one backup that's near there, but you also want your stuff offsite. And obviously you get that with a lot of different companies, but the speed of Backblaze, I mean, the word blazing comes to mind. I uploaded, it was like 600 gigabytes, and I think it was either 9 or 16 hours. I had used another company's services before that, and it took 3.5 weeks. So the speed of getting this up there, the speed of getting it back, our friend Pat Dengler, I've talked about a lot on the phone, she's a on the show, she's a Apple certified consultant, and as a test, she had a hard drive fail. She had used the service that Backblaze has where you can be shipped a hard drive, take the data off and ship it back, or vice versa. I forget exactly which. Worked perfectly, flawlessly, so she didn't have to wait for all the data to come back down.
Yeah, that's our snapshot program. If you want up to 3.5 terabytes downloaded from your account for $89, we put it on a U.S. thumb drive, ship it out to you, and if you return it back to the company within, I think it's 30 days, your money's refunded. So it's basically
You pay a little bit.
$89 at first.
You get it all back? I thought you paid like 20 bucks or something.
3.5 terabytes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's our snapshot.
So it might not be a thumb drive. Might be a small drive.
Yes. Yeah.
Unless, but I want to know where you got an $89 3.5 terabyte thumb drive, and that's what we're really talking about today.
We buy a lot of drives. And
I bet you do. Well, thank you so much.
Right.
If people want to learn more about Backblaze V2, where would they go?
It's backblaze.com. So we have all our products listed up there. There's a contact sales. We're very much of a transparent company, so there's a lot of documentation up there. Tech support's available. You can always set up a test free account. The first 10 gigs are free, so anyone can feel free to set it up and see if it's a good fit for
them. We got some video that we haven't put off site yet, so maybe we'll check into that.
We should talk more. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
All righty. Thank you, Allison.